latest to, as we begin this morning, special coverage of the COVID outbreak in Melbourne and a new alert impacting thousands of fans at the MCG. The city is reliving a nightmare with a ballooning number of exposure sites added to the list. The cluster has grown to 9 after another 4 people tested positive and restrictions have returned.
OK, so let's take you through some of those restrictions now, and starting with private homes. Private gatherings at homes are down to 5 people. Public gatherings, of course, that limit is at 30 people this morning. Masks are compulsory indoors to anyone over the age of 12. Restaurants and bars remain open. Weddings and funerals can go ahead, but with mask rules observed, and schools and workplaces can also stay open with mask restrictions, including for secondary students.
OK, well, let's go now to Christine Ahern, who's at the G. And contact tracers are working around the clock to contact thousands of fans who attended a game between Collingwood and Port Adelaide. Chris, a positive case attended the game.
Yeah, that's right, Ali. And there were 23,000 people at the Port Adelaide-Collingwood clash here on Sunday at the G. So this is not the news Victorians needed this morning. This infected person was seated at Zone 4, Level 1 of the Great Southern Stand, the Punt Road end. So the advice, if you were seated in that area, self-isolate and get tested. QR codes and CCTV is being used by health authorities to try and identify the affected people. This weekend's footy round is very much in limbo. The AFL waiting on further advice from health authorities about possible crowd caps, which could be as low as 50%. Ticket sales were frozen yesterday. The Western Bulldogs had to go into isolation and also get tested after a staff member attended High Point Shopping Centre. Training is expected to resume today. Saturday's match between Essendon and Essendon and the West Coast Eagles over in Perth is expected to go ahead despite the requirement for all Victorians to get tested and self-isolate till they get their result upon arrival in WA. The NBL is also in chaos. Melbourne United and the South East Melbourne Phoenix have temporarily relocated to Queensland for the foreseeable future. Melbourne staring down the barrel of another lockdown. This is the first significant outbreak of the Indian variant in Australia, and revelations that the man dubbed Case 5, who could be the missing link, spent 10 days in the community while infectious.
Ali. Gee whiz, thanks, Chris.
Testing clinics across Melbourne are being pushed to the limit, with some wait times blowing out to more than 3 hours. Reporter Isabella Stashkowski joins us from a testing clinic in Epping. Isa, these clinics are bracing for another spike this morning.
They certainly are, Carl. Good morning. They were pushed their absolute limit yesterday, some reaching capacity within minutes of opening, and no doubt we will see the same today. We are here in Epping at the epicentre of this COVID crisis, and it might be harder this morning to be getting testing here because this facility actually says it's closed due to weather. That is a great concern. We have contacted the health department to clarify what is going on here. Meanwhile, with ballooning exposure sites, we are expecting, of course, more people to be getting more tests today. You'll see on your screen in a moment a list across Melbourne. This is just new tier one exposure sites. That means if you have been there, you need to immediately get tested and isolate for 14 days regardless of that result. There are now more than 20 exposure sites. All of that information on the health department website, and the stores at High Point where a case attended have now been identified. They include Kidstuff and also Ishka. In response, 26 testing facilities across Melbourne now do have extended hours, but the message still is to shop around. You do not have to go to the testing facility closest to you. You can go on that website, see the locations and find one with a low wait time. So you are encouraged to, of course, do that if you do need to get a test today. Carl.
Isa, thank you.
The outbreak in Melbourne has been linked back to the Adelaide Hotel quarantine system. Nine News reporter Mike Lorigan is there. Mike, good morning. How did this happen?
Good morning, Alex. Well, the early indications are that it is spread through the air in the hallway when food or linen is dropped off to guests and their doors are open at the same time to pick them up. An official investigation into this has now wrapped up. The initial infected man caught the virus after a person who was staying in a neighbouring room tested positive to coronavirus and was then transferred to a neighbouring hotel. As I said, the investigation has now concluded. Health authorities are expected to make that report and its findings public as early as today. The Premier here, Stephen Marshall, has indicated his government will act on key findings, all the findings and recommendations from that report, and they are expected to be looking at the way food is delivered in the hotel quarantine system here in South Australia. Alex?
All right, Mike, thank you. And Perth, Adelaide and Canberra will be fighting to host the opening game of the State of Origin series as COVID-19 threatens to wreak havoc on the event. The opening game was meant to go ahead at the MCG in less than a fortnight, but the new outbreak is casting a dark cloud over those plans. Contingency plans are being drawn up in case the match needs to be moved.
A warning of more blackouts for Queensland after the biggest power outage in decades impacted almost 500,000 people across the state. We have team coverage, starting with today Queensland reporter Reece D'Alessandro in Brisbane. Reece, this power failure caused absolute chaos.
Yeah, most certainly did, Ali. And as we go to air this morning, further power cuts have not yet been ruled out, but it created chaos right across the state, including at the Wesley Hospital behind us. It was emergency surgeries only. Elective surgeries have had to be rescheduled. The same goes at the Mater across Brisbane and at Gold Coast University Hospital. Emergency backup power was needed to keep the lights in the intensive care unit on. It was also chaos on the roads. Traffic lights were flashing yellow right across the southeast, but especially along Gympie Road leading out of Brisbane. There was a traffic nightmare for a number of hours yesterday afternoon. Shopping centres also weren't immune. We saw hundreds of customers doing their grocery shopping in the dark. This morning, I can tell you that connections to almost 500,000 Queenslanders who were impacted by this outage have now been restored. Energex crews have been working round the clock to get those connections restored, and I can tell you they have all now been restored. But as we mentioned off the top there, further blackouts, Ali, have not yet been ruled out.
OK, thanks, Reece.
Let's go now to Nine's Sasha Hanapel, who is at the Callide Power Station in central Queensland, where it all happened. Sasha, what's the latest there this morning?
Went to buy emergency services, but it's not clear exactly how long it's going to be until it's back up online. It'll be months before the damage is repaired. The fire happened around 1:45 here yesterday afternoon in one of the turbines, which forced three of the units to shut down, causing that domino effect right across the state. An investigation is already underway to determine exactly how that happened, and we understand hydrogen has been isolated to avoid any explosions. CS Energy CEO Andrew Bills is on his way to Billawilla right now today.
All right, Sasha, we've got some problems with your audio there. We'll try and come back to you a little bit later, but a lot of personnel on the scene there at the Callide Power Station, the scene of that fire yesterday. Lots of work to be done to shore that up. And when it's back online, we're not sure yet. Alex.
A safe injecting room has been approved in Melbourne CBD despite widespread outrage. A motion opposing the room was defeated during a council meeting last night, with Lord Mayor Sally Capp maintaining evidence showing the service could save lives. In a statement which has just been released, the City of Melbourne has called on the Victorian Government to consult with local businesses and residents before a location is selected. One family in New South Wales say they've been left homeless, blaming the mice plague for burning down their home. Today, Sydney reporter Gabby Boyle joins us with more on this. Gabby, good morning. This is horrific. What do the family have to say?
Absolutely horrific, Alex. Well, the Ward family are simply grateful that their three young children, their dog and cat all managed to escape the home safely before it completely burnt to the ground. The property is outside of Narrabri and it is understood that the fire has broken out in the roof of the family property, and police believe mice have eaten through the electrical work and that is how the fire has started. Absolutely terrible. The home completely destroyed. But as I said, everybody managing to get out okay. A full investigation is now underway. Of course, we've been hearing in recent months about this terrible mice plague that's been affecting regional communities. We're now being warned that it is heading towards our cities. These mice have even been spotted in parts of Western Sydney, places like Parramatta and where I'm joining you from in Erskine Park this morning. The New South Wales State Government has set up a $50 million fund to try and get on top of this problem. But certainly the last thing we want to see is it heading towards our cities, where it could very quickly get completely out of control. Alex?
This problem not going away, Gabby. Thank you.